Brady, did it seem a little bit like, you know, there was not a huge crowd tonight, and it seemed like early in the game it was just kind of flat in the stadium a little bit, that it took you guys a while to get going?
I don't think it was the stadium that made us come out flat. I didn't think we came out that flat, you know, just something, we just had some penalties, and that just kind of, that kind of turned the tide a little bit with our, we're like, man, we kind of got down on ourselves a little bit, but I said, just keep playing, let's just have fun, we're okay. Let's just keep things going, and we had ended up executing later, but we were just beating ourselves was the main thing that took air out of our sails with holdings and things like that. And everyone's out hunting, it's hunting season, so we understand that, you know.
Shayne, it's 14-0, and then you guys punt down there, pin them deep in their territory, then they got that 91-yard touchdown.
Yeah.
That feel a little bit like a missed opportunity, like if you'd have got that stop there deep in their territory, maybe you could have put them away right there.
Really, after that play, we weren't concerned, because at that point, I think maybe they had 9 or 10 yards of offense. We already had 2 or 3 3-and-outs. And so that's a big emphasis for us this year, has been trying to eliminate the big play, and obviously that was a big play, and but we came off the sideline and we're like, hey, that's all they got. If they have to, if they're gonna have to bank on us, you know, missing tackles or just us not doing their job, you know, we're going to get things cleaned up, and that's they're not going to be successful all night with that. And so even going into half, you know, they had the one long run and, you know, that screenplay. And so we weren't disconcerted from that. You know, that didn't discourage us or anything. We just knew that if we kept playing the way we were at that point, which we had a few 3-and-outs, things were going to clean themselves up.
What was the did Stick get after you at halftime? Because, I mean, you come out in the third quarter and boom, 21 points like that.
All the coaches were pretty disappointed, and we understand why. It's because we beat ourselves. It's not like Missouri State was physically dominating us. We just had penalties. We just weren't playing how we know we can play, and we're still searching for that perfect game, you know, like we always talk about, where everyone does their job on every play. And so that was kind of disappointing, but we answered the call second half. Everyone responded well. We didn't just hang our heads, you know what I mean? So we just played the second half as a brand new game, new start.
Did it feel good for you guys to for the running game to get going like it did?
Yeah, it did feel good. I mean, we're all, everyone in that room, it's funny, all of us scored. It was, that's what we were laughing about. It's really cool. We have Goddard and Winicky, obviously, and Taryn does a great job passing the ball to those guys. So whatever we got to do to win, if it's blocking for 40 plays or whatever it takes. But it was cool. We had some opportunities this game, and so it was just nice to answer the call, you know.
Good to see Kyle Paris back
in.
Oh,
yeah, awesome.
Short yardage
awesome
situation.
Yeah, I was starting tearing up thinking about all the time he's put in, just like us. And he hasn't got a single play. He's a senior year. You know what I mean? He played a decent amount last year. So it's just crazy. It's really cool for him to get in there. And he's just a selfless guy that's really leads and serves in the running back room. We have a bunch of guys like that. Whatever takes the win, whoever's in the game, obviously Kane Lesher doesn't get the ball a lot either. And he still just goes out every day just trying to do his job. So it's just really cool.
Shayne, you kind of alluded to it defensively. Some big plays was really sort of all they got. How do you evaluate a game like that where it seemed like most of the game you kind of dominated, but then there's those few big plays that bit you?
Yeah, and Brady kind of touched on us. It's just that fight for us to try and be perfect, to put that perfect game together. You know, like I said, other than those two big plays, we had a lot of 3-and-outs. And so it just comes down to us doing the fundamentals. You know, we had missed tackles on those plays. It wasn't the big play itself. It was us not executing fundamentally like we have earlier in the season. And, like, and that's a big focus for us. That's a big emphasis. We attempt to get better at our fundamentals every single week. And so we don't see it as a 91-yard pass play. We see it as a missed tackle here, an over-pursuit here, you know, not chasing the guy's hip down like we practiced since first day of fall camp. And so really it's not scheme-wise or coverage-wise or something-wise like that. It comes down to us executing our fundamentals like we've been attempting to do and, like Brady said, trying to be perfect at it all season. So,
are you guys thinking about potentially winning a conference title, things like that?
It's not on our radar right now. That's not our thought process. You know, we're not thinking, you know, before this game, we're not thinking, oh, if we went out, we're going to win the conference. We go about accomplishing our first goal of the season that the seniors and captains established, which is to go 1-0. Want to know the play you're doing, want to know that series, you know, and then it, which leads to us going 1-0 tonight against Missouri State. So we can't get too far ahead of ourselves. Obviously, we're aware of it, and we talk about how our goals are in front of us to accomplish, but, you know, that's step number 47 down the road, and we're just trying to focus on the one step in front of our face to accomplish that. So,
Brady, was there a sense, though, this week of trying to flush what happened last week, move forward?
Yeah, it always is hard the next week after a loss, you know, just because you just felt like you're a better team. You got to win this game. And so, it's just, I mean, you put so much time into every single week. Every loss is hard. But, yeah, it was nice just to, I mean, you just focus on the next game, Missouri State. And it was just nice. It is nice now after that win to, oh, that's all flushed out of the system. It is nice.
Well, now the team from down south is coming up next week.
Yeah.
I got to imagine that's a game you both are looking forward to.
Yeah, it's always fun. Obviously, it's, you know, Coach Stig doesn't overhype it or anything like that, or even, you know, NDSU, he doesn't overhype any game. He doesn't overhype any certain game. It's just that game that week. And so, but we know that, you know, they kind of look at it perhaps in a different way, that it's, oh, it's us, they're coming into our house, you know, they're maybe, you know, thinking about it a little more like that. But for us, it's the team in front of us. It's a faceless opponent to just accomplish that. But, you know, I'm sure everyone will kind of talk about it or allude to it in some way. So,
well, you're a South Dakota kid. Are there some guys on that team that you know, or?
I don't pay too much attention to it, but they try not to. But I mean, there's a few guys I know from kind of Mary who tried to go down there or do something like that. But it's I just kind of remember the whole deal. They, you know, weren't as invested in some guys as SDSU was up here with, you know, me and certain other guys. So it's that's really the only difference I'd say for that. But it'll be a fun game because it's the only one we got.
It's the most important game because it's the next game.
Yeah.